Now, will you listen to this, beginning with verse 5, chapter 1 of Luke. There was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zacharias of the course of Abiah, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. Now, this is where God broke in after 400 years of silence. Dr. Luke begins chronologically first in the New Testament. He goes back to the birth of John the Baptist, and he goes back of that to where the angel Gabriel appeared to his father yonder as he served in the temple. Now, the very interesting thing is that we have here two names, Zacharias and we have Elizabeth. Zacharias means God remembers, and Elizabeth means his oath. God remembers his oath. That's a strange thing. Here's a couple, that their very names are very significant. God remembers his oath. Well, when did God take an oath? Oh, way back yonder, you recall God said to David, "Once have I said to David." And not only did he say it to David, but he says, "I took an oath, and I will not lie, that I'm going to bring one in his line that's going to sit upon his throne." May I say to you, that's a remarkable statement. I'm going to read it. It's in the 89th Psalm, verses 34 and 35. Listen to this. "My covenant will I not break, nor alter the thing that's gone out of my lips. Once have I sworn by my holiness that I will not lie unto David. His seed shall endure forever, and his throne as the sun before me. It shall be established forever as the moon and as a faithful witness in heaven." May I say to you, friends, it says here that Zacharias and his wife Elizabeth, we have God remembers his oath. What is his oath? Why, he took an oath to David that he's going to bring one in his line to reign. Here he's coming, friends. This is just the announcement that he's on the way, that God is ready now to break through into human history after 400 years of silence. Now, will you notice it says they were both righteous before God. That is, they were right with God. How were they right? Well, they were right because they brought the sacrifices that recognized they were sinners. But their walk was also a walk that commended their salvation. Notice what it says. They were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless. That is, when they did make a mistake or sin, they brought the sacrifice. Now, here was the tragedy of their lives, though. They had no child because that Elizabeth was barren, and they both were now well stricken in years. Old couple, and they didn't have a child. And that was practically a disgrace for a Hebrew woman. And now we find he's serving there at the temple. He belongs to the tribe of Levi. And now let me read on, verse 8. "Came to pass that while he executed the priest's office before God in the order of his course, according to the custom of the priest's office, his lot was to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord." Now, he served at the golden altar. That's the altar of prayer. And he was serving there. It was the time of the evening sacrifice. And the whole multitude of the people were praying without at the time of incense. Now, that particular part of the service, he's putting incense on the altar. There appeared unto him an angel of the Lord, standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And when Zacharias saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him. And that's a normal reaction, is it not? If you saw an angel, what would you do? May I say that the same reaction this man? You'd be troubled and fearful. Now will you notice? "But the angel said unto him, Fear not, Zacharias, for thy prayer is heard." And you know what he was praying for? Praying for a son. You know what his wife was praying for? She's praying for a son. I think a lot of the people were praying for that. I believe in asking God's people to pray. I asked God's people to pray for me when I found out that cancer had gotten into my lungs. And people have prayed. I thank God for the prayers of God's people. And so he's in there praying. He's praying for a son. And how do I know he's praying for a son? Because the angel said, your prayer's answered. It's been heard. Thy wife Elizabeth shall bear a son, and thou shalt call his name John. This man Zacharias is very much like a lot of us. Thou shalt have joy and gladness, and many shall rejoice at his birth. He shall be great in the sight of the Lord. He shall drink neither wine nor strong drink, and he shall be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb. Now, this boy that's to be born is to be a Nazarite. Now, we'll get that in the next book, back in the book of Numbers, when we go back there. The rite of the Nazarite. It was a vow that a man would take. And one of the things that a Nazarite did, he wouldn't drink wine or strong drink. And that was, he's finding his joy in the Holy Spirit and in God. That's the reason Paul says, be not drunk with wine. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Get your joy from God, not from a bottle. We got a lot of bottle babies today, let me tell you. And I don't mean in a crib. I mean hanging over a bar stool. And I think we got some Christians today. They have to be pepped up, to hepped up in order to face life today. We need to recognize the Spirit of God can do that for us.